Okay, what's up, guys? This is your boy, Ampu. Thank y'all for tuning in to my video. This is going to be an introduction and a questionnaire, a Q&A that I'm doing with all of my friends and family and anybody who just wanted to know a little about me traveling and going out of the country. But before I get into that, I want to say thank you, guys. Appreciate it. Make sure you hit the like button and subscribe. I'm trying to help this channel grow. Basically, what this channel is going to be about is me reviewing and giving you brutally honest reviews on places that I travel to, restaurants, hotels, when I'm skydiving, skating, surfing, doing a lot of fun things like that. And I also want it to be very informative because a lot of people don't get to travel abroad and they ask me a lot of questions. So I want to ask, like, how hard is it to get a passport, or what do I do on a plane for 12 hours, or are they receptive to Americans? I get a lot of questions and things like that. So I'm about to hop into this Q&A. I got a lot of great questions for you guys. Stay tuned. Okay, guys, let's hop into this Q&A, all right? Let's go. Let's see what we got here. So my first question is from my mom. Shout out to my mom. I love you, Mom. She said, how was the hospitality in Mexico? Great question. The hospitality was amazing. I'm going to be doing some more in-depth videos about my trip to Mexico. So I don't want to give too much information out about that. But the hospitality was amazing. Everywhere that I went, they just were so happy to see me and stuff. I went to 4 different cities. It was pretty cool, though. The hospitality was great. Billy. Okay, Billy has a question for me. He said, do they speak English in restaurants and hotels in Mexico? Oh, Billy, that's a really great question. That's another great question. It depends on where you go, because no, they don't. You know, I was in Guadalajara, and no, they didn't. At any restaurant, they barely spoke it. At any hotel, they really didn't. So, I mean, you got to go certain places. A few Mexicans do speak it. I went to Puerto Vallarta, and they, you know, some of them did. But no, they don't speak it a lot of places. Even when I went to Barcelona, like, oh my God, it was a nightmare. Okay, next question. Shout out to my producer. This is from him, Coney. He said, how was the weather in Mexico? Okay, that was a whack question. The weather is probably like in California. It's about 85 degrees. It's real humid. So it kind of like in New Orleans. I'm from New Orleans. So if you guys are familiar with weather in the South, it's real humid, about 85 degrees. The weather was really good, though. Another question he had was, is traveling exhausting? Yes, traveling can be so exhausting, especially when you're, I live in America, so when you're flying to like Europe, hell yeah, it's definitely, I mean, plane rides are like 12, 13 hours, you know, and that's a direct flight. So if you don't get a direct flight, your plane ride can be like 18 hours, you know what I mean? It's 12 hours to London, and you have to sit on a plane the whole time, so it's definitely exhausting. Okay, another question I have is, what do you do on a plane to pass time? Great question. These are some great questions. Like, I'm so excited to answer these questions. That's a really great question. My first time flying out of the country, it was like, oh my God, I didn't have anything to do. I was so pissed. I was on a 13-hour plane ride, and that shit was just awful. Excuse my French. So the next time, I came super prepared. I was playing like Plants versus Zombies. I had downloaded like a lot of Netflix movies. When you're traveling out of the country and when you're going on a long plane ride, just make sure you have like something on your phone or an iPad or something where you can watch movies, and that'll help pass time because you will not be able to sleep on the plane. All right, let's get it. Now, this question is from my boy, Sean, who I play with on Marvel vs. Capcom. Shout outs to Sean. That's one of my favorite people to play with online. He said, do people treat you differently abroad because of your skin color at restaurants and other places? They definitely treat you different. They definitely. Now, whether that's in a good or bad way, it just depends on where you're going. When I was in Mexico, I got treated really well because a lot of the places I went, they thought I was famous or some shit. They really don't see too many black people. I've been to 10 different countries, and most of the places that I went, I've got treated pretty cool. England, it was like, nah, you know what I mean? So it just depends. If they think you're American, and sometimes they might get excited, or sometimes they can just be like, oh, we don't like Americans, you know? But I do think that for the most part, you're okay, you know. But, you know, it's just like America. It's just like hit or miss. Okay, my nephew, Lil Walter, he asked me, do they play basketball in Mexico or did I see any courts? No, that's a great question. I didn't see any. Basketball is one of my favorite sports. I try to play once or twice a week. I didn't see any basketball courts, you know. No, I didn't see any. I think soccer worldwide, once you leave America, soccer is like that sport. Like, you know, it's just like soccer or maybe boxing. But other than that, man, nah, they don't play any basketball there, from what I noticed. Okay, Maggie, shout out to my sister-in-law. She asked me, did I see any drug trades at a cartel? Oh, my God, I'm doing another video about that. No, I did not see any cartel stuff or any drug trades, any fights, none of that. It was completely cool. And I went to Guadalajara, I went to Puerto Vallarta, I went to Nuevo Puerto Vallarta, and I hope I'm saying that right, and Sayulita. And I went surfing there, so no. Tony asked, do the Mexicans girls look better than the ones in LA? That's a good question. That's a good question. Oh, man. Jeez, that's hard. I think the Mexican girls in Mexico look better, though. Definitely. Okay. My dog, Smitty, somebody I work out with, shout out to Smitty for help keeping me in shape. He asks, how's the fashion? Man. Okay, so in Mexico, it's no in between. It's either like they're dripping in damn Gucci or either like they're just not wearing anything, you know, whatever. It's like they're really like, I don't know, like hypnotized. It's definitely different from here. I feel like in a lot of European countries, I feel like they're on fashion really hard. Like the men in England, they wear like little man purses and stuff like that. So the fashion is different. I want to say Europe is, like I said, it's just way different. In Mexico, it's like I said, it's high or low. Either they're dripping in damn Gucci or either it's just like something normal, okay? Shout out to my boy Damage. This is another gamer friend that I have. He asked, did I like Mexico or Barcelona more? Definitely Mexico, hands down Mexico. I think Barcelona was a great place, but definitely Mexico. My dog Drift asked me, is it hard to get a passport? No, Drift, it is not hard to get a passport. I remember when I got mine expedited. So I think altogether you have to get a picture and pay for it. I don't know. It was about $300 or something, but it might not be that expensive. I just know that I got my passport expedited. So it's definitely not hard to get a passport. If you have any questions or anybody have any questions, y'all can just DM me on Instagram and I'll help you out with that. Black Calf asked, how was the food? Okay, the food in Europe is fucking awful. Ooh, I'm gonna bleep that out. The food in Europe is awful. Like, that's awful. The food in Mexico was pretty good. You know, that was pretty good. Oh, not all of Europe. I'm sorry, because I went to Germany and Austria. Their food was amazing, you know, but the food in England was awful. The food in Mexico was just like, the food in Mexico was good, but the food in England, oh my God, they think McDonald's and TGI Fridays is just like, what's popping? It's like, bro, I haven't ate McDonald's in like 12 years. I don't eat McDonald's. But the food in Mexico definitely was good. My dog Coggins, best player on Marvel vs. Capcom on Xbox. This is him. He asked me, what is the most surprising thing that I've seen? Okay, the most surprising thing that I've seen is the amount of graffiti. When I travel in Europe, it's like, it's crazy because like the impact that hip hop has on the world, you just never would know unless you travel out of the country. And it's like everywhere that I go in Europe, it's just like filled with graffiti. And they even have certain places where you can just like spray paint and do your graffiti, and the government like assigns that area. But when you're here in LA in America, it's like, no, you'll like go to jail for that. Another thing I've seen is like, oh my God, like I just think prostitution is just like at an all-time high when you leave the country. So that's something that's very surprising as well. Shout out to Nada, special shout out to her. She really supports me. She said three places that I would definitely visit again. Three places that I definitely will visit again is Austria, love Austria. Let's see, Mexico. Oh my God, I just fell in love with Mexico. And let's see, the third place would probably be, Africa's cliche, but I don't know. Those three, definitely. Well, oh man, I'm getting stuck here on this. Definitely Austria, definitely Mexico, and maybe Jamaica. You know, maybe Jamaica. Okay. Most exciting thing I've ever done out of the country. Most exciting thing I've ever done out of the country. I don't know. Probably like surfing in Puerto Vallarta or Mexico or something. I do a lot of exciting things. So sometimes the scenery is exciting, but also it's like I find learning exciting. So whenever I get to visit a museum or something like that, like in Austria, there's a lot of history. They started World War One and World War Two. So it's like definitely like when I get to visit like a good museum or learn something, that's definitely exciting to me. Have I faced any fears while traveling? I'm definitely going to do a video on this. Yes, I have faced fears while traveling because the media just makes you think that, oh my God, you're going to get taken like Leon Nelson or something if you go out and you travel. And I think you're going to be a little bit apprehensive, especially if you don't go with a group of friends. So you're always going to be a little bit like nervous because you don't know anything, you know? So I definitely have faced fears though. But I try to stay positive. I'm a really positive person. So I think when you think negative, you receive negative. If you think positive, you're going to get positive. So I just try to stay like as positive as I'm going to get. And if something happens, it just happens. I'm just a positive person. Okay. Next question. What place is overrated? America. Like definitely America. Okay, but definitely which place is overrated is England. Oh my God, London is so overrated. Don't go there unless you have friends, because it's like everybody just seems so down. It's like when you talk to people and you tell them you're from America, they're like, oh my God, what you come here for, mate? It's a shithole. You could have came anywhere in the world, but you come to here. Oh, I can't believe you waste all your money to travel here. So definitely the people are very down. The food's not great. I don't know. I just definitely would not go to London. Or I think a lot of European countries are just overrated though. When you travel, you want to go somewhere like very sunny, because that tends to be like where the people are the happiest at, you know? Like you want to go somewhere very sunny, and you also want to go somewhere where you get a bang for your buck. If you're going to these European countries, sometimes your dollar's worth a little bit less, so you end up spending more money. So a great tip would be to go somewhere where it's a little bit cheaper, and especially if you don't make a whole lot of money. Okay, let's see. Another question I have is from my dog, Muscle Mike. He says, what happens if you get a traffic ticket in Mexico? Bro, if you get a traffic ticket in Mexico, no lie, bro. You can give the police like $20. Like, the police officers aren't there like trying to hound you for tickets and take you to jail. But I know my Mexican friends, like if they get stopped or something like that, it's just like, hey, here's $20. Have a nice day, officer. Okay. My little cousin Maria, she asked me, how do people react to seeing blacks? Great question, Maria. Great question. Like I said before, when you go to certain restaurants and stuff and you go to certain places, some people think that you're like maybe a celebrity or something. I know I get that a lot. Oh, what are you, an actor or celebrity? So it depends on how often that they see blacks. Some is just like normal for them, but a lot of places, like when you're in certain parts of Mexico, they like literally have no blacks. So it's like I got like great welcome. It was like, you know, people were taking pictures with me, we were smiling, they made sure I was comfortable, so I loved it there. Picasso asks, does the Coke taste different? I don't drink soda. Picasso is, shout out to Picasso because this is my dog too. I don't drink Coke, Picasso, so I don't drink Pepsi, but I know that they're different ingredients. My wife said, what city has the best food? Easily, New Orleans. Easily, New Orleans has the best food. Point blank, period. Nobody's messing with New Orleans food in the world or in the country. Okay. My brother asks, did I feel safe in Mexico? When I first got to Mexico, I did not feel safe. I've heard so many bad things about it. Like, oh my God, they're going to steal your organs. The cartel is just running up and shooting people. Oh, and the Dominican Republic is like, they're killing people. Okay, so it took me a little bit, but once I got there with my friends and stuff, it was just like, dude, this is crazy. It's like the safest place in the world. I couldn't believe it. I didn't see any crime, anything suspicious, or anybody getting robbed. It just was crazy. I felt so safe. But I want to tell you this. A lot of people ask me, do I feel safe in when I travel? I don't feel safe in Chicago. I don't feel safe in Los Angeles. I don't feel safe in certain parts of New Orleans or in Detroit. So when you're going out of the country, sometimes it's going to be the same thing. But I can tell you right now, you know what I mean? Like, if you're in downtown LA or some shit like that, I mean, like, geez, watch where you park your car. You're not going to feel safe here. You know what I'm saying? And he said, is it true that some places hate Americans? Definitely. Definitely, I think some places hate Americans. And I don't think it's for this narrative like that, you know, some people say they just hate us for no reason. I definitely do think that they have a reason. And I'm not saying that it's justified, or I'm not saying that it isn't justified. That's not my place to decide. But I think the reason why some countries do hate America is, one, because we're very dominant in a lot of sports. So we're constantly, like, beating their asses in all kind of sports. Another thing is, too, I hear that Americans are very loud and flamboyant, and they don't like that. And three, America does have this reputation of kind of like being a bully. So I think that some places that you go, they don't like Americans. But, you know, half the places I go is like, I'm African that speak English. But anyway, guys, thank you for sticking through the whole Q&A. I really appreciate it. Just stay tuned. I'm trying to give you guys more informative information about traveling. I want to answer a lot of questions. Anybody that knows me know, if you want to ever go somewhere, just follow me on IG. And wherever you want to go, whether it's a restaurant, it's a hotel, if you know me, if you don't know me, hit me up. We can go there, shoot a video, all on me. Thank you for watching my channel, The Hard Truth. Appreciate it.